So, welcome back at STEMEXCO TV. Now a very, very special guest, Tessa Violet, joining us.
Aw, thank you.
Hi, welcome. She's a singer and songwriter and, of course, a YouTube star. So for everyone out there not knowing Tessa, you will get to know her now. And in a few seconds, if you follow the live stream, which I know it's unfair because this is going to be on demand, so you missed the live stream, but it's going to be recorded anyhow and you can see her stage performance. So my first question is, welcome first, of course. I'm happy that you made it.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here.
What would you do if Google would decide to shut down YouTube tomorrow?
That's a fantastic question, one which I think about. I mean, at this point, I'm sort of halfway transitioned into singer-songwriter, and I'd really love to make performing and singing and touring a career. But if it were to be, what if you couldn't be an entertainer anymore? I've always been really interested in counseling, and I'd probably want to be a counselor.
Okay. How do you motivate yourself? It may sound a little odd, the question, because you're young, you know, you're good looking, you're full of energy, you're on stage, you're a star, but we all know that stars have some mornings where they're not in the best mood, and what do you do then?
That's a good question. My friend John Rubin told me once that amateurs wait for inspiration and pros get to work. And as a creative, sometimes we trick ourselves into believing that it's something that only comes when it comes and you can't control if you feel inspired, but a lot of the craft of being creative is knowing that it's a craft and learning the habits of what gets me in a good space to create. What does it feel like to create if I don't feel like creating? Can something good still come from that? And I write songs from 9 to noon every day, sometimes longer, but I try and write a half song every day, and sometimes they're great, and sometimes they're not, but it's being willing to know that it's worth doing, even if it's not the best.
It's pretty much disciplined every day from 9 to 12. Wow, I'm impressed. Which are the three brands you couldn't live without?
Twitter, Canon, Airbnb, this is more, Bose, Pimsleur, any brand that wants to work with me. But there's a few I love. Canon is so amazing. I've been with their cameras for like 6 years now. And Twitter is my favorite social media, I think.
I think this is not the typical audience in a few seconds when you're on stage. But if you look at your audience, what is your typical audience, young or old?
A lot of young women, ages 14 through 24. And the ones who are on the older end have been with me since they were young.
What about groupies, young or old?
Groupies. I'm really lucky that my audience is largely a creative and interesting group of people who I don't feel like I have a lot of interactions with fans where they feel maybe overwhelmed like maybe a groupie would. It tends to be a lot of really interesting conversation.
So they drop a mail, they contact you, or?
I guess I mean in person.
Okay. Wow. Which musician influenced you really heavy?
Well, of course, I have to give a salute to my queen, Taylor Swift. And I also love Miniature Tiger's first record, Tell It to the Volcano. I love Hello, Goodbye. I really like Fun, Nate Roos. A lot of people. I love pop music, but I also love really interesting lyrics. And now we're seeing a trend in pop music and what's on the radio where we see more and more deep thinking lyrics, and I enjoy that.
As we put the slides together, and of course everyone sees their singer slash songwriter, which part of you is stronger in your person? Is it the singer or the songwriter?
Ooh, I'd say the songwriter. I'm not... I would sing as a hobby if I couldn't write songs, but I don't think I'd pursue it as a career. I like the vulnerability of being honest in your songs, and there's something interesting in getting to stand in front of people and say, you know, hey, here's something private. in the form of poetry and music. There's something special in getting to connect with people that way.
So songwriting is more fun, if I can put it that way.
My friend once said it best. Writing songs is the worst. Having written songs is the best.
Was there a certain role model or an idol for you in your professional life? A mentor, somebody you looked up to?
I love Taylor Swift. I do. I like that she's so thoughtful in interviews, and I like how kind she seems. I read online once that someone said, when I was young, I valued intelligence, and now that I'm older, I value kindness. And I feel that way now.
That's a very nice saying. Since you're doing this, I would say for a professional living, of course, who's your most important advisor? Is it a typical management? Is it a good friend? Is it?
Good question. I work with Maker Studios, but I don't have management or a publicist or an agent. So I guess I speak to my friends. My friend Shauna Housen is here today. And
hi.
my boyfriend Rusty Clanton is also in YouTube. I have a lot of people who work in the same industry and bounce around ideas and do you think this is good. But it is a lot of self-driven. And I mean that in the least self-involved way possible.
I know this one is really hard, but is there an all-time favorite song you have?
It'd be hard to pick just one, but I love Words Remain by Josh Garrels. He's a worship artist. And I love Hot Venom by Miniature Tigers, which is that record I mentioned. That whole record is so good. I really love sad songs generally. Things that evoke feeling forlorn is an interesting experience.
So, two more. Who is your most weird fan, and do you know him or her?
I don't know. I guess the easy answer for that, I could say, my mom. She's seen everything I've ever made, and she's so wonderful and encouraging. The fans that I get to interact with are just so encouraging and so wonderful. I would hesitate to use weird with a negative connotation because I think weird just means different, and different is wonderful.
Of course. I totally agree. How do you relax if you don't have enough energy for the 9 to 12? What do you do the evening before or the minute you wake up and I got coffee and then an hour or something and then I got to get going? So what do you do?
I love Netflix. Right now I'm watching The Mindy Project, Doctor Who, and The X-Files, which they just put on Netflix from the beginning. That's an experience.
Okay, folks, so whenever you need some relaxation, watch those series, enjoy your coffee, and then go back to your desk at 9 and work till 12. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to see you on stage.
Thanks so much for having me.
And all of you guys should be there watching as well. So see you soon, I hope, and all the best for your career.
You too.